Kapla Mutaiba.
William Samoei Ruto of the Kenya Kwanza Alliance. Presidential Debate 2022. Do not adjust your sets.
Every day, over 15 million members are transforming Africa.
And a very good evening to you. This is Easy Friday. My name is Shiksha Arora. Thank you for choosing KBC Channel 1 to bring to you the top news tonight. We're going to be having all the news that you basically need to know. We've got sports news, business news, and of course what's happening in the country. After that, we'll also be having Spotlight, where I've got Magunga, the videographer, content creator, ace photographer, who will be on the show live. So we'll be having a discussion with him later on. All that happening right here on KBC Channel 1. My name is Shiksha Arora. You can interact with us. The hashtag is Easy Friday, but for now, it's time for the highlights. Protecting the child. President Uhuru Kenyatta signs bill raising criminal responsibility age from 8 to 12 years. Campaign promises. Kenya Kwanza and Azimio teams concur on need to address high food costs. Caution on the road. Road safety drill is conducted at Kinale with heavy fog being reported in parts of the country. This is Easy Friday. Our sign language interpreter is Lucy Mwaura. Now, the top story tonight. President Uhuru Kenyatta has signed into law six bills, among them the Children Act of 2021, that has attracted praise from the public on its benefits to the minors. Some of the highlights in the Children Act is that the criminal responsibility age has been raised from the previous 8 years to 12 years. Children accused of committing minor offenses, according to the new act, will now be diverted to community based systems such as their family. Sarafina Robi with more details on the story.
It is no mean feat for children in Kenya after the president assented into law the 2021 Children's Bill, among six other bills, as it comes bearing huge perks in seek for justice. According to children's lawyer Cynthia Odongo, the Children's Act has sealed major loops that existed in 2001 Children's Act and sees this as a step in the right direction.
It is now bringing to life what we have been advocating for all these years. From the Children Act 2001 to what we have now.
According to Clause 221, Subsection 1 of the Children's Act, a person under the age of 12 shall not be criminally responsible for any act or omission. This implies that the criminal responsibility age has been raised from the previous 8 to 12 years.
To find an 8-year-old criminally liable you'd not really find much ground to support what we call the mens rea.
The Act under Clause 56 says that Parliament shall appropriate monies for the National Council for Children's Services. Other sources of funding for the Council include grants, gifts, donations, or other endowments given to the Council. Meaning there will be a welfare fund created for children. Family lawyer Dunstan Omari explains how the new law that states that children accused of committing minor offences will not be taken through court systems. Rather, they'll be diverted to community-based systems.
So the parent, the first punishment provided for diversion is reinstating or restitution of what the complainant is asking. Is an ADR, an alternative dispute resolution, which falls under Article 159.
The other major benefit is that children with disability will now be accorded medical treatment, special care, education and training free of charge, as the Act also introduces kinship adoption, recognizes kafala, the taking in of a child who is deprived of parental or family care and protection by a person professing the Islamic faith. This has been celebrated by Kenyans on all platforms. Seraphina Robi for Easy Friday.
Moving on, religious leaders from central Kenya have committed to help the electorate make wise decisions in the August polls. Now, the cleric who spoke during an interdenominational prayer service at State House Nairobi said that they would continue preaching peace during the electioneering period. President Uhuru Kenyatta thanked the leaders for their steadfast support, attributing the progress achieved in his tenure to God's guidance. Take a look.
President Uhuru Kenyatta Friday hosted religious leaders from 21 counties from the central region for a worship and prayer service. While lauding the spiritual leaders for their key role in preaching peace and love to citizens, the president noted that the progress achieved during his tenure was largely due to God's providence through the clergy's sustained divine intercession.
Tuko na sababu nyingi sana za kumshukuru Mungu wetu. Sababu nyingi sana. Ona tuwe na madhena. Ni atuigite tuwe kidu kimwe. Nagatuiga tuwe na dhayo. Nagatuwe muoyo.
The leaders promised to continue guiding the congregants to make right political choices during next month's general election.
Every high priest is selected from among men and is appointed to represent them in the matters related to God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins.
Without peace, there is no development. Without peace, there is no happiness. Without peace, there is no joy. We pray that these elections will be peaceful. That's what we desire. That's what we believe in. And that is what God will grant this country.
Calls of a peaceful election and coexistence were echoed during the service, with Kenyans being asked to continue spreading love and unity regardless of tribe or religion that one is associated with.
na moja ile kana nikugite kahinda guikarite kwina thayo bururi wa Kenya ta kahinda gaka tukoretwa twinako todo gutire kindu gikuraga utari ki utari thayo.
Frederick Muki for Easy Friday.
All right, and my camera operator was actually translating for me what the president said. I know what he meant word for word. Moving on. Deputy President William Ruto has promised to lower the cost of living if elected president next month. Now, campaigning in Nakuru County, the Kenya Kwanza flag bearers said he would lower farm cost of farm inputs as a strategy to achieve food security.
Kenya Kwanza presidential candidate William Ruto took his campaigns to Nakuru County at a time a section of Kenyans have threatened to boycott general elections if the government does not lower the cost of living. The deputy president pledging to prioritize lowering cost of farm inputs as a strategy to lower cost of food.
Na tumesema mpango yetu number one, mahali tuliwachia, tunarudisha mambo ya kilimo na tumesema lazima tupunguze gharama ya maisha. Hiyo mbolea inauzwa 6,000, tutapunguza mpaka ikuje shilingi 2,500 hapo chini.
Popularizing his manifesto, Ruto pledged to allocate 200 billion shillings to expand textile industry and food processing. The second in command promising the people of Naivasha that if they elect him, would turn the town into an industrial city.
Uhuru Kenyatta alituambia tumsaidie, tulimsaidia. Akasema yake itakuwa 10 na William Samoei 10, tumebadilisha.
Sisi tumekata kwa kauli moja ya kwamba taifa la Kenya halitamwaga damu tena kwa niaba ya mwanasiasa yeyote.
We are marching forward to the unity of the nation. Hatuwezi kurudi nyuma mahali siasa ilikuwa inapiganisha watu, inagawanya watu, inalete shida, inamwaga damu. Good people of Nakuru, mimi, I want to give you my commitment.
In the name of Jesus.
Isho Kiwashira, Easy Friday.
Now, Azimio la Umoja One Kenya Coalition Party presidential candidate Raila Odinga now blames the high cost of maize flour on maize imports into the country. Odinga claims maize imported from Mexico not only destabilized prices of the commodity, but also discouraged farmers from growing the crop. Raila, however, says should he succeed President Kenyatta, his administration will subsidize farm inputs to make the country self-reliant in food production. Wycliffe Okech has that story.
Odinga Friday returned to Western Kenya region, this time pitching camp in Kakamega County and seeking to rally the over 700,000 registered voters in the county behind Azimio la Umoja One Kenya. Odinga made several stopovers in the county, among them in Likuyani and Malava, before addressing a rally in Shinyalu. Odinga blamed the high cost of maize flour being experienced in the country on maize imports, claiming prices were destabilized and farmers discouraged from engaging in large-scale growing of the commodity. The former Prime Minister said if elected president, his government will make the country self-reliant in food production by subsidizing farm inputs.
We will finally make a global farm subsidy. Okay,
The coalition, while taking a swipe at their opponents in Kenya Kwanza, reiterated its firm stand on corruption.
William Ruto alikuwa naibu wa rais Andrew Mtu. Miaka haya yote hakujua kama iko mtu anaitwa Musalia Mudavadi, hakujua kama iko mtu anaitwa Moses Wetangula, hakujua kama watu wanataka maendeleo.
Wanasema Waswahili kwamba bila naye kupenda mbali namna gani? Bila naye kupenda anapenda kufanya nini? Baba ametupenda. Na baba amepatia vijana wetu mheshimiwa Mbeto kufanya kitu cha kuweka pesa ya Kenya.
Sisi watu wa Kakamega kwa kauli moja tumesema ya kwamba mwezi wa nane tarehe 9 tunapigia serikali ya baba na
for Easy Friday from Kakamega County. I am Wycliffe Okech.
Now, Inspector General of Police Hilary Mutyambai has called on Kenyans to collaborate with the police to ensure peace during and after the polls. Mutyambai at the same time cautioned the public against being used by politicians to settle political scores. Here is Andrew Okero with the report.
The Inspector General of Police Hilary Mutyambai was in Makueni County in the ongoing National Peace Walk campaigns. Here, Mutyambai presided over the opening three police stations of Tawa, Kidhungo and Ngon Police. He also presented three vehicles to the stations in a bid to enhance security in the region ahead of the August polls.
We have been here without us giving a penny. They have even given us houses for our officers. We are going to do whatever it requires. This station becomes habitable and operational.
Mutyambai also calling on the public to be wary of politicians out to use them for political mileage. In Nairobi, police officers from the Central Police Station held a peaceful walk within the Central Business District to sensitize Kenyans to embrace peace during and after elections. Nairobi Central Region OCPD David Mburukwa urged Kenyans to vote peacefully in the August polls to avoid post-election violence, encouraging citizens to be vigilant in the defense of their democratic rights.
Nataka amani na tunahubiri amani. Tulianza asubuhi kitu saa 3, tumesunguka CBD yote. Tukiambia wananchi tunataka amani, tunahubiri amani, tunataka hata wakati wa election kuwe na amani.
This is an initiative which is being carried out throughout the country. Of course, we have our partners, Special Olympic. These are the people who originated this idea. And in every election cycle, where there is violence, we are at the core, we are at the front line. So we are asking members of public to observe peace.
Sentiments echoed by a section of Kenyans who are calling for peaceful polls, saying a more stable country is a pillar to a stronger economy.
I think there might be peace, but you never know with politicians. So now kill them, Kenya, just to maintain peace regardless of who we are living with. And for the politicians, don't push anything. Results ikitokea, we just kubali and accept it.
I'd like to call for peace, and also having spoken to a few of my friends from countries that are war-torn, especially in the Middle East, I can say what we have as peace is gold, and we should not put it so much into our hearts. The politicians, that's their job.
With a few days remaining to the general elections on August 9th, temperatures are still high as the mood of whether there will be a positive outcome of the elections. Religious leaders and today police and Special Olympics Kenya have held a peaceful walk on a call to action to caution Kenyans on the need to conduct peaceful election. This not only sets the pace for Kenyans to follow, that indeed, if we unite as one people, then everything is manageable.
Andrew Kero for East Friday.
All right, and with that, it's time for us to take our first commercial break. We'll be back in just a moment. Remember, keep interacting with us. The hashtag is Easy Friday at Shiksha Arora at KBC Channel 1. Where are you watching from? Do let us know.
Ukwe maskini lakini ukwe mzima.
ukiwa na health mzuri, shukuru Mungu.
Some of them don't even understand the kind of sickness that they are suffering from. But thank you, because through mama here, we have seen the hand of God.
Nashukuru, nilitibiwa, sasa naendelea kupona.
Lakini mulisupport, nikaweza kupona, sasa niko na raha, Mungu awabariki.
Nilikava kabisa, niko na furaha sana.
The only show that is transforming lives.
Mungu akubariki na Mungu akuzidishie.
Part of the MLW AAA Super Series, the catch wrestling powerhouse, Davey Boy Smith Jr. The revolutionary high flyer, AAA's Hijo del Vikingo. Well, it's either going to be MJF or Mance Warner representing MLW, but which one? Wait, the MLW World Heavyweight Champion, a member of Contra Unit, the Samoan smashing machine, Jacob Fatu.
You know, they say you don't choose family.
She's not my family. Jackie, msipigane.
Alinishika hivi, akanirudia blouse nilikuwa nimevaa.
I'm sure it's something that you've thought about it before, right? Explain why you left Jason.
We will never, never, ever talk about it again.
Girl, glad to see you two happy. What do you want?
Easy, Tanga.
I want us to start over again. This one more time.
Welcome back. Now brace yourselves for the cold. The National Disaster Management Authority, National Transport Safety Authority, in conjunction with St. John Ambulance on Friday, held a drill to create awareness on road safety along the Nairobi-Nakuru Highway. The awareness creation has been necessitated by increased road accidents attributed to fog, especially along the Nairobi-Nakuru Highway. Ruth Wamboy reports.
This was the situation early morning along Nairobi-Nakuru Highway. The road has been experiencing accidents owing to the mist that is witnessed at Kinale Forest area, affecting drivers' vision. A drill was held at the black spot with two dummy accidents to measure the level of preparedness in such eventualities.
Also to carry out awareness campaign for those road users so that they can be aware of what they need to do. And again, we are also sensitizing those who may be involved in rescue operation in case of any emergency.
Taendesha magari katika ile njia ya kuendesha na mwendo wa kasi. Na katika harakati hiyo, haangali climate hapa ya. Ukiwa katika njia kutoka pale Lironi kukuja pande hii, njia inakuwa ina utelezi mwingi.
Drivers plying the Nairobi-Nakuru Highway calling on the government to install lights along Kinale area.
Ile misti kwa huko juu ni mbaya. Hata asubuhi kulikuwa na road accident mbaya sana pale Rari juu ya misti. Kwa hivyo madereva waendeshe gari polepole, waache mataa na waache mbio. Hiyo barabara ni slippery sana kutoka Limuru mpaka Nairobi.
Lazima uwakishe taa na upige hazard na uende kama 10 km per hour. Ukikimbia hapo utagonga magari, ama ukisimama kwa barabara mbaya utagongwa na gari matwera ikiteremuka. Kwa hivyo hiyo watuwekee kubwa bara walijenga mpya waweke mataa.
In the streets of the capital city Nairobi, the weather was dull with elusive sun being a much sought item by Nairobians, but to no avail.
Baridi yende, lakini hata kujivaa, hakuna hata usaidizi yote. So, ni kujikaza tu.
With temperatures lingering below 17 degrees Celsius, the streets of Nairobi hosted otherwise a competition for the most warm wardrobe, with Kenyans donning hats, scarves and heavy jackets to protect themselves from the biting cold. With mist and fogginess expected to be in the country for the next 3 months, Kenyans are advised to wear warmly and drivers plying such routes to take precautions to avoid accidents. Reporting for Easy Friday from Nairobi County, I'm Ruth Wamboi.
So, yes, make sure you stay warm. Now moving on, Kenya's COVID-19 positivity rate has dropped to 9.2% from Thursday's 11.8%. This follows the confirmation of 228 new cases in the last 24 hours from a sample size of 2,471. The total confirmed positive cases now stands at 335,569. Now, according to statistics from the Ministry of Health, no death was reported in the last 1 day, with accumulative fatalities remaining at 5,660. Data from Johns Hopkins University COVID Resource Center shows that over 553 million COVID-19 infections have been confirmed globally, with more than 6.3 million deaths being reported since the beginning of the pandemic. Now, the Council of Governors is calling on President Uhuru Kenyatta to direct the National Treasury to disburse over 29 billion shillings owed to the counties for the month of June in the 2021 to 2022 financial year. The Council regretted that the delays in disbursement has stalled several development projects in the counties and risks burdening the incoming governors with arrears and debts from their predecessors. Take a look.
The inception of devolution saw the introduction of county government in Kenya, and 10 years later, second-term governors are bidding farewell to the top county seats. Their legacy was lauded during the launch of the State of Devolution address book today, with the Council of Governors Chairperson Martin Wambora taking stock of milestones in devolved governance.
The volume of agricultural export increased by 4.5%. Three, during the review period, the volume of marketed milk increased by 26.6%.
Despite these achievements, the governors lamented that the perennial delay in disbursement of funds to counties with over 29 billion shillings still pending has crippled service delivery in the counties.
Because unless this money gets to the ground, people are suffering. Prices of fuel are up. Prices of food is up. People in the villages are being strangled with poverty.
Additionally, the National Treasury should allow counties to transact through IFMIS until the 15th of July 2022.
Defense Cabinet Secretary Eugene Wamalwa, who served as Devolution Cabinet Secretary, said the government is in the process of coming up with fresh devolution policies to improve service delivery in the devolved units.
We will be coming to you, pioneer governors who are leaving, even as we shape that devolution policy for the next 10 years. Your contribution will be invaluable, and we still hope you will be with us to chart the journey ahead for the new generation of governors who are coming in.
Once more, that I will continue supporting devolution, because it is the one which will accelerate balanced development at the grassroots level.
Dr. Smokin Wanjala, who represented Chief Justice Martha Koome, said the cooperation between the devolved unit and the judiciary has ensured justice is served even at the grassroots levels.
It is almost inevitable that the success of the devolution project will often be judged by its ability to bring about more accessibility, representativeness, legitimacy, openness, participation, innovation, inclusiveness and accountability.
The second time governors that are leaving office are calling on the governors that will ascend to power come the next government to ensure that service delivery to the people remains their biggest goal. Isofar reporting for Easy Friday from Westlands, Nairobi County.
Now in politics, Roots Party presidential candidate George Wajakoya has promised to reboot the country's economy if elected, in the August polls. Wajakoya claimed the country has enough resources for self-sustainability.
Roots Party presidential candidate George Wajakoya took his campaigns to Meru County. Here, Wajakoya promising to revive the economy if elected president. Residents lauded the 10-point manifesto outlined by the Roots Party leader, saying it will transform the lives of Kenyan voters.
Good morning once again.
This, as Wasingishu Women Representative Gladys Boschulei has urged women seeking elective positions in the August poll to stay the course, despite the obvious challenges and obstacles they face as they seek to expand their participation in elective politics. Speaking during a women leadership breakfast in Diani, Kwale County, Shulei said that she is confident the next parliament will have more women legislators who will bring tremendous change.
Lazima uingie chama. Ushughulike ni chama gani, lakini ingia chama na uhakikishe kwamba ukiwa kwa hiyo chama upiganie nafasi ya wakina mama, kwa sababu huwezi kupigania nafasi ya wakina mama ukiwa nje ya siasa. Hata mabadiliko kwa hii nchi yote inatendeka katika bunge, so kama wanawake hatuko katika bunge, then hakuna kitu itabadilika kama ni budget pro.
They want to see a situation where women gain the rightful position in society, where our youth gain the rightful position. After all, we did the katiba and we put youth there, we put people of the marginalized people there. So they want to see a situation where there is equity.
General elections.
Elsewhere, Bomet Governor Professor Hilary Barchok says there is no need for IBC to revert back to manual voting. Speaking at Lulisik area in his country during a campaign rally, Barchok said the security integrity of this year's election was going fully electronic, noting the biometric indicators were available to identify.
As a country, ninachue ya kwamba, we have invested a lot of money in terms of ensuring that we digitize our register. Yes. And it will not make sense kama tutarudi nyuma kuenda manual. I know there are a number of biometric indicators ambayo tunaweza tumia to identify a voter wa each and every polling station.
Now, 5 years ago, President Uhuru Kenyatta gazetted the recognition of Kenyans of Asian descent as the 44th tribe in Kenya. This week on My Culture, we focus on the exhibition of the calabash by the 44th Kenyan tribe of Asian origin at the National Museums of Kenya.
For many years, the presidency and other government offices received numerous petitions from Kenyans of Asian heritage requesting the formal recognition of the community as a Kenyan tribe. 5 years ago, their wishes were granted. In July 2017, President Uhuru Kenyatta gazetted the recognition of Kenyans of Asian origin as the 44th tribe in Kenya.
In mid-May 2017, His Excellency the President received a petition from Kenyans of Asian heritage who requested that they need to be recognized as part and parcel of Kenya's family. And therefore, by gazette notice, His Excellency the President accepted and legally gazetted the recognition of the Kenyans of Asian heritage as the 44th community of Kenya.
The recognition under the presidential proclamation came after President Kenyatta granting similar recognition to the members of the Makonde community, originally from Mozambique, as the 43rd tribe.
Yangu ni kuomba radhi kwa sababu imechukua muda mrefu ndio tufike kiwango cha kuwatendea haki kama wakenya wenzetu.
At the National Museums of Kenya, a group congregates for a noble cause. It has been 5 years since President Kenyatta gazetted the recognition of Kenyans of Asian origin.
We feel proud because one, after 100 years in Kenya, we are now fully recognized as a tribe.
The group is here to represent Kenyans of Asian descent to present the National Museums of Kenya with a calabash from the 44th Kenyan tribe of Asian origin as a custodian of natural and cultural heritage that will be placed at the Hall of Kenya.
I have got different sects of religious beliefs within the Asian community. We've got the Hindus, that is a religion now. Then we've got the Sikhs, we've got the Govans, who are Christians. We've got the Muslims, the Shias, the Bahuras, the Sunnis, the Ismailis, the Parsis also. We've got very small, minute numbers of 10 individuals. So it was to bring them together.
Prior to the event, a coconut is broken.
To wunja the coconut, even on a wedding, any function you are going to, this is, and it's not just us, the Kenyan Arabs at the coast do the same thing.
To commence the event, a drama leads the group towards the Hall of Kenya, where the function will culminate. The Hall of Kenya is dedicated to highlighting the country's unique tangible and intangible heritage. It is in this gallery that Kenya's nature, culture, and history meet. The centerpiece consists of hundreds of gourds collected from different communities all over Kenya. Made from fruits of plants, the gourds vary in size, shape, and color. The gourds are used for storage, measuring, and fermentation. The centerpiece in the Hall of Kenya consists of hundreds of calabashes celebrating the rich heritage of all communities in Kenya.
The Kenyan calabash, those behind, were placed in 2007 by the National Museums. There was an organization that went around collecting calabashes from every tribe, and they were placed here. Okay? We have done it in conformity with the other tribes who placed theirs.
It is here where the group exhibits the calabash, a symbol of unity in diversity, as a historical moment. The pioneers of the 44th Tribe of Asian Heritage, led by Farah Manzo, said this was a step in the right direction after the formal recognition by the president, which meant that all persons, bodies, and authorities within the country shall recognize the community in line with Articles 11 and 44 of the Constitution of Kenya that protects the duty of the government to promote and protect the diverse cultural heritage of Kenya. This even as they called on the community to continuously play a more active role in society.
After the 44th tribe, I've seen a big impact. We have young generation coming out to vie for elective posts. So pole pole, tutafika.
Reporting for My Culture, I'm Jackie Wambiru.
Kupata mafuta kupanda kama Skiza Tune kwenye simu yako, bonyeza *811*962#.
Na shukuru serikali kwa kuongeza bei ya mafuta. Sasa niko kwa highway na kuna traffic kata kidogo. Naomba serikali endelee hivyo, tubaki tu watu ya Gasla na heavy machine peke yake. Pia mimi naomba huyu serikali waseme kama gari yako ni below 3000 cc, gari yako na baki nyumbani, itengeneze nyumba ya kufuga kuku.
Kupata na mafuta kupanda, bonyeza *811*962# *811*962#.
Aya.
Differently. Once you already have like an LPU evidence that you're able to deliver, somehow you start getting into the system. So persistence in business is very important. Even if you're getting those small ones, as much as you're aiming for the higher ones, the small ones are a source of encouragement.
I can see the results in the students' eyes. I can see the joy that music brings to them, and that completes me.
We're differently abled, differently.
As Tribe 44, I've also learned something very new from that My Culture segment, because, you know, within Tribe 44, there's semi-tribes, and of course, it goes on and on and on. But yes, a story for another day, which I was talking to Betty with. So we're going to definitely get back to news right now. Betty, what do we have in business tonight?
Well, we have a lot lined up for you, but on that story of the 44th tribe, the calabash is symbolic and it's very common in Kenyan tribes, so indeed the Asian community belongs. Let's get into the business news. My name is Betty Kiptum. Now, Kenyan health technology company Afya Record has launched world's first completely automated universal patient portal built on blockchain technology. Health experts say the platform will transform patient medical record access in the country. ICT Chief Administrative Secretary Maureen Baka says the government has reformed the country's ICT policies to attract more players to innovation in the digital space.
Medical records are an important tool in the management of health, keeping historical records of patients, healthcare professionals, and medications administered to patients. However, medical record system in Kenya is in shambles, with many patients and medical practitioners struggling to access it. Stakeholders say another challenge facing the Kenyan health system is the lack of interoperability when accessing medical records, forcing many patients to carry physical health records.
We all stand up. UPP!
To deal with the problem, Kenyan health technology company Afya Record has launched the world's first completely automated universal patient portal, built on blockchain technology.
We see that we have ICT being incorporated in health. As government, we encourage, you know, the up and comingness, the having such apps in place. And we, of course, we do this by creating an enabling environment for, you know, the establishment of such apps.
The Afya Record system allows patients to create a portal with all their health data and gives patients sovereign rights of ownership of their data. The patient logs in and sees all the information from every healthcare provider they have interacted with.
The problem we're trying to solve is the accessibility of healthcare data. When it comes to your healthcare data, most people at best will have their prescription from the last hospital visit. They don't understand the value of having accessible your health information.
The value of data in healthcare is extremely important, especially in emerging markets where we belong, Africa, Kenya, all these countries, because the use of data can help us reduce the cost of healthcare. And more importantly, can help us save more people's lives, which is what we all want to do, and can help create an integrated healthcare ecosystem.
Now, as demand for Kenya's coffee rises, farmers have been urged to venture into and increase production. This comes after Kipkelion Farmers Cooperative had a supply deficit, failing to meet demand from South Korea. The cooperative society, comprising of over 9,000 smallholder farmers in Kericho, Nandi and Bomet counties, have received assurance from the investors of good prices for coffee beans if they are availed.
South Korea is the fifth largest consumer of coffee with 170,000 metric tons per year, previously buying its coffee from Colombia and Brazil. The country last year shifted its focus to Kenya as a supplier, striking up a deal with Kipkelion Cooperative Society that saw smallholder farmers directly engage in trade with the importers. The country is further exploring more opportunities in the huge demand. One of South Korea's leading roaster, Goodbin, says it has agreed to purchase the commodity from seven cooperative societies in Kenya. The seven are Machakos, Muranga, Meru, Mount Elgon, Bungoma, Kipkelion, and Kisii Coffee Societies. Goodbin Chief Executive William Kang has said good quality coffee is in high demand in South Korea, urging farmers to increase production as the market is readily available.
And I'm confident that it will lead to the farmers more profit.
To open up this market, let everybody compete for the farmers' coffee.
Speaking in Kisii County, the Presidential Task Force on Coffee Sector Reforms Chair, Professor Joseph Kieya, has said the development is as a result of reforms that the government has over the last 3 years undertaken in the coffee subsector.
The revolution we've been waiting for has come. I want to assure you that you'll be getting good prices for your coffee. All we need you to do is to continue producing quality coffee.
That is the way where the farmers are going to get three benefits from farming. It is you as private farmers and them as private buyers.
Kenya is a major producer of coffee in the world, where its Arabica and Robusta varieties are popular among roasters the world over. Hibak Said for Easy Friday.
And tea production in the country has recorded a year-on-year drop of 3.12 million kilograms owing to depressed and erratic rainfall and the effects of La Nina weather conditions in tree-growing areas. The Tea Board of Kenya says the adverse weather was more prevalent in East Rift counties of Kiambu, Muranga, Nyeri and Kirinyaga, where the first half of April, which is usually a peak month of the long rains, was characterized by dry weather, forecasting dreary outcomes even in the coming year.
Tea production recorded in April this year dropped to 41.1 million kilograms, a 3 million kilo drop from 44.3 million kilos recorded last year. This number falls even shorter than the records in March 2021 when Kenya had produced 46.3 million kilos of tea. The Tea Board of Kenya is now sounding the alarm over the drastic production drop, mostly attributed to the adverse effects of climate change. Tea production in the first 4 months was lower than that of the previous year by 8.28 million kilos, standing at 177 million kilos. In areas east of the Rift Valley, there was a drop of 4.06 million kilos in output from 14.54 million kilos. In the west of Rift Valley, the effect was largely felt in Nandi County, but the region still had a marginal increase of 0.93 million kilos. In the first 4 months of 2021, the country cumulatively recorded 185.3 million kilos. Parts of East Rift Valley recorded extremely dry conditions with precipitation of between 2 to 10 millimeters daily in the period. The total export volumes for the month of April this year were lower by 20% from 49.4 million kilos last year to 39.6 million kilos this year. The decline in export volumes was majorly due to lower demand and the effects of the Russia-Ukraine war. Kenya tea was shipped to 45 export destinations compared to 46 last year. Local tea sales also dropped, with TBK reporting a 4-month cumulative decline from 11.3 million kilos to 10 million kilos. TBK says due to depressed rainfall recorded in March and April this year, the trend is likely to continue throughout the rest of the year. Hibak Said for Easy Friday.
We now move to our weekly segment, The Savage Netizens. And this week on the segment, we interact with discontented keyboard warriors who have been feeling the inflationary pressure surging. While there is very many different constitutional rights that allow Kenyans to question the government on tough economic times, netizens would rather turn to social media to voice their discontent and hopefully grab the attention of the powers that be. Take a look.
Long ago, our forefathers will toughen themselves up to deal with the hard times. Nowadays, netizens just ask for the uwe emoji to deal with the hard times. Take a look at what we've prepared for you this week on Savage Netizens.
For quite a while now, Kenyans have been waiting for the uwe emoji to use as a reaction to any tough situation. The appeal to Mark Zuckerberg for the uwe emoji creation was drafted by a Twitterati, and it has gained great traction on social media. The appeal goes something like this. Hello, Mark. On behalf of all Kenyans, I am requesting your team to make uwe emoji. Uwe should be made to carry heavy emotions. We use it to say a lot of things. Example, if a person borrows me money in this hard economical time, I can just reply with uwe. When we see the fuel and cooking oil prices, we usually just say uwe. Mkenya Alisi wrote, that emoji should be ready by now, cause uwe ni kubaya. Angira Elvis, ile emoji ya uwe isha tengenezwa. This is serious. But now, the expressway accidents this week has made it to the uwe list of keyboard warriors who are wondering, what is not happening? Otoki tweeted, careless driving at its best. Joseph wrote, erect speed bumps at every exit of the expressway to avoid unnecessary accidents. Architects responded, how will they see a speed bump if they can't see a toll station?
Chai! Chai!
Collins, guy flew into the expressway.
Oh my God!
KJM tweeted, ukiwa hiyo barabara ya chini, huwa unaona ni kama gari zina fly expressway bana. Bye. Joe and Gav, the word exchange went like, Joe, huyo msewa Prado was paranoid, aka lose control of the wheel while accelerating. Shout out to Uhuru Kenyatta. Igathe, sasa unashautia Uhuru out amefanya nini? Hehe, laughing emoji.
Nakwambia upuzi ambao uko Kenya ni mwingi sana.
To be clear, we do not know which Uhuru they were talking about. Anyway, this week's Mima's request due to tough economic times also strongly feel that Niko poa nikungangana tu should be added to the national anthem.
Well, that's it for us this Friday. Catch you next week on Savage Netizens. For Easy Friday, I am Teresa Mutai.
Teresa Mutai does it again. Well, that's it for the business news this evening. We will be bringing you the sports news. That is Shiksha Arora on the other side of the studio. My name is Betty Kiptum. Do enjoy the rest of your viewing. Bye-bye.
Ivi tu si ungefanya nini?
Bar mi angeshika yo mtu. Put him in a tree. Remove all the clothes. Have a razor blade. Alafu na gatagate yama pieces kadogo kadogo kama ile ya nyenyewe.
Omera, this is my phone. It is not yours.
Of course it is yours, but it is tapping.
Why are you people intruding into my personal life?
Hey, lata munda yangu. What is wrong with you? Let me go, you crazy. Why are you crazy? Lata munda yangu.
No, come here.
We shall legalize weed.
Professor George Luchiri Wajakoya of the Roots Party.
Semeni Babakea! Babakea!
Raila Amolo Odinga of the Azimio la Umoja One Kenya Party.
Unajua mimi sina pesa ya serikali ama ya cash fund.
David Mwaure Wahiga of the Agano Party. And
hakuna kura ya hasla mtaiba.
William Samoe Ruto of the Kenya Kwanza Alliance. Presidential Debate 2022. Do not adjust your sets.
All right, in sports tonight, teen sensation Angela Okutoyi and Holland's Rosemary Njikamp are in the finals of the girls' doubles at Wimbledon after they defeated third seeds Lucia Sirik Bagaric of Croatia and Nikola Dobnerova of Slovakia in the semifinals. Okutoyi and Njikamp won 6-3 to 6-4. Now they will face the winner of the match that pits the team of Nikola Bartunkova and Celine Naef, and that of Kyla Cross and Victoria Mboko. Angela was ousted in the first round of the Wimbledon following good run at the Australiana and French Open Grand Slams. Now, the Kenya athletics team will leave on Monday for the World Athletics Championship in Oregon, scheduled to start from the 15th to the 24th of July in the USA. Now, Kenya Broadcasting Corporation, KBC TV, will broadcast the 9-day championship.
The Kenyan team boasts of defending champions Timothy Cheruiyot, Hellen Obiri, Conseslus Kipruto and Beatrice Chepkoech. Timothy will be defending his men's 1500 meters title, while Obiri and Beatrice Chepkoech will be out to retain their 5000 meters and 3000 meters tipoches titles respectively. Race walkers Samuel Gadimba and Emily Ngee, who recently won Africa titles in Mauritius, will be seeking to replicate that form in Oregon.
Mimi naona nitakuja na medal. Nitakuja na gold. Na kisha wa Kenya nitakuja na gold. Na ni maombi yangu. Unajua kila kitu mpaka uweke Mungu mbele. Nime train, hiyo ingine naachia Mungu.
Pande wa mazoezi na hiyo kudabo kutoka round to Commonwealth imepangwa vizuri. Manake sijawahi ndabo. Lakini mwaka huu nimeweka yangu na nisafanya vitu mbili kwa wakati moja, sababu concentration ndio maana sana.
Africa 5000 meters champion Beatrice Chebet has graduated to the senior levels where she hopes to carry on her winning ways.
Tumetrain vizuri, so kila kitu tu ni kwenda kung'ang'ana na kufocus tu.
Kutoka Kenya kwa World Championship tuko wasichana watatu, kuna Naomi Kori na Charinta Mawia na mimi. So watarajie tu mazuri, tutangangana mari tunaweza. At least tuone pia sisi kwa hiyo eventi tunaipigania. Tusiache hiyo mwanya ikuwe refu, tunajaribu kuifunga.
Meanwhile, Wycliffe Kinyamal will be out to reclaim the World 800 meters title just like he did in the 2018 Commonwealth Games.
It's my first time to be in the team for World Championship and for Commonwealth. It's the second time I'm going there to defend my title. For World Championship, tunaenda pale, tunaenda kuungangana. Si eti tunasema, tunajua kenye tunaenda kufanya, but we are going there to try to do our best.
A total of 47 athletes to represent Kenya at the 2022 World Athletics Championships are due next week in Oregon, USA.
Mashindano yangu naenda ya pili ya dunia na nimejitayarisha kwa sababu ya doa ilikuwa ya mara ya kwanza na najua pia kugraduate kutoka junior mpaka senior si rahisi, lakini kwa saa hii naweza sema at least si kama venye ilikuwa na 2019. Experience hii imegrow na matokeo itakuwa ni tofauti na 2019.
Right now, let's cross over to Machakos. We've got Dan Mwendwa, who's got the latest update from the Machakos rally. Dan, what's the latest?
This is the first edition, which will be held starting tomorrow at the Machakos People's Park, tomorrow and on Sunday. And without wasting time, we are joined by the one and only Team Joseph. So welcome on board, and just brief us on how the preparations are as per now.
Yeah, preps are all good. Drivers have all been briefed. So tomorrow we start, and we've got a full day of rallycross, the first time we've ever done it, so there'll be a lot of learnings. And a lot of the local drivers who have entered have never raced door-to-door. So it's going to be fun, it's going to be interesting, and we'll see how tomorrow goes.
So do we expect to see you on the wheels?
Yeah, for sure. It's the first time I've sort of participated in the main event, racing against Baldev Chaga tomorrow. So that'll be interesting. So I hope he's kind, and we'll have some fun.
What do we expect from you?
To get round and don't break down. Yeah.
Do we expect any prizes? Are there any prizes for the winners?
Yeah, so absolutely. I think for your winner, it's your kudos of winning. We got some good prizes, and for the finalists as well, because there's a final on Sunday morning where the top four cars and teams move through. So yeah, there'll be some good prizes.
Thank you so much, team.
Thank you.
We're also joined by George Juguna, one of our own, who will be on the KBC's, one of the KBC's sponsored driver. Welcome on board, George.
Thank you so much.
So how do you feel now?
Well, I'm so excited, ready for this day tomorrow. And our team, KBC team, is ready. And we think we are ready. We are ready. Yes, yes, yes.
Having a sponsorship from KBC, and we can see that you are the only sponsored team by the national broadcaster. How does it feel, and what do we expect from you?
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank the sponsor, KCB. This is our first event, and we are looking forward for so many events with KBC. We are so excited. I've been racing for so long, and I think in my rallying career, I think this is my first sponsorship, and I'm so excited. So I'm looking forward for this day, Saturday and Sunday, and we are ready for it. The car is ready, and we are waiting for the day just to roll off. Yeah.
So lastly, as we're going to wind up, what do you have to tell to your fans?
Well, being the first rallycross in Kenya, we are expecting a lot of people. Yeah. This one for the 2 days, and I know spectators, they just come and watch, and then they just be careful. I think the organizers have taken care of the safety for spectators. They are spectating zones, and I think all the spectators will be happy on the way the setup is done.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
So that was George Juguna, and we will be updating you anything how it goes on tomorrow at the Machakos People's Park. Back to you to studio.
Thank you very much, Dan. That's the update. Of course, it's going to be a star-studded event. Lots of talents there, and we'll make sure that we'll give you all the updates from Machakos at the upcoming Machakos rally. And with that, it's time for me to cross over to the other side. We've got Magunga Williams in studio, and he'll be telling us about his journey in the creative industry. Magunga, hello.
Hi.
That was a very short and sweet hi, but it's fine. We'll get in-depth with him later on. Crossing over to Cole Jax, who's also ready on the other side of the studio with lots of music for you. It's Friday. Remember, hashtag Easy Friday. That's how we do it right here at KBC Channel 1 every Friday. Loves to feel like a star. Cole Jax.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I knew you were when I met you. Nearly tamani ni kupeleke kwetu. Good vibes and I'm grateful. Hapa nitapanda mbegu. You deserve to feel things you never felt before. Love you like I never did before. You don't know what's in store for you. Melanin and so much more. Heavy is your crown.
Heavy is your crown.
The way you hold me down. Every girl deserves to feel
place in the game.
Welcome to Easy Friday. I am Shiksha Arora with you. Remember, if you'd like to interact with us, the hashtag is Easy Friday at KBC Channel 1. Tell us where you're watching from. Lots of feedback coming in. Shout out to Paul Wekesa, who is tuned in. Thank you so much for your company. It's a pleasure keeping you entertained. And of course, we've got Magunga Williams in studio, our guest tonight for Spotlight. The Spotlight is on this guy, photographer, videographer, ace content creator. I actually met him on the streets of Twitter like a few years ago, and then I got to know a little bit more about him and how diverse he is in the different things that he does. Just by the way, a fun fact, he's actually an incredible salsa dancer. That's how we became friends. The love for dance just brought us together, and here we are at in studio at the Easy Friday set. Welcome on board.
Thank you. Finally, I'm here.
Yes, you're here. You finally made it.
I had to accost you on social media, you know, for you to bring me here, but I'm so happy to be here.
Well deserved, Magunga.
Thank you.
You know, you've been doing a lot of things off late, right?
Yeah.
First started off with photography. You know, your pictures were phenomenal on Twitter, always going viral, always being shared so widely. And then recently you've gone into content. You've been doing a lot of content creation for different brands. And then you covered the rally, which, by the way, you did incredibly well.
Thank you.
I watched your recent video. And I have to say, it looks like you've been doing video for a long time.
No, I haven't. Uh-huh. I haven't. And you know me from my photography days.
Yes, of
days,
course.
But before that, I used to run a blog.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. So I think Nad is my pool of followers are so confused, because there are people who started from the beginning, and I used to run my blog. It used to call the Magunga, and I used to tell stories, writing.
Okay.
Writing is how I started.
So you were a writer first?
I don't know if someone ever stops being a writer.
Okay.
But yeah, people, writers write, and I've not been writing that often, so I would say I'm no longer one. But yeah, so I started writing, and writing is what basically put me in the limelight. Photography came as a by the way, honestly.
Wow.
Speaking, there was a camera in there was a camera around.
Okay.
And I picked it up, started taking pictures. It just so happened that I had a lot of photography friends, guys who were in the photography field. And all I did was just ask them, show me this, how do I do this, how do I do this? The rest I did on YouTube. And
wow.
Then video,
yeah,
is barely a year. It's, I think, the beginning of this year old. I've not done video that much. I wouldn't even call myself a videographer, but I've always believed that YouTube is a university by itself.
Absolutely.
Yeah, with the help of my other friends like Goofy.
Google.
Yeah, Goofy, Pau, those are now guys who I have to appreciate for helping me.
No,
yeah,
I mean, we've got some incredible talent in the country. And of course, you know, once you're on the internet, you also get to learn so many of these things by force, even though you like it or not, through Google, through YouTube.
Yeah, and you see, the thing is, I used to write my blog,
yeah,
but then times change and mediums change. The time when I was writing, that's where people were reading blogs,
yes,
gossip, entertainment, creative writing, everything was written. And then things changed. You know?
Wow, interesting.
Yeah.
So what did you study in school?
I went to law school.
What? Now I am completely confused. So you went to law school,
yeah,
ended up writing a blog,
yeah,
and then became a photographer, and then got into content creation, and now you're a videographer. I mean, you say you're not a videographer, but I've seen your videos, and I can proudly say that you have got some great skills. So here we are.
Yeah, so I mean, we were not born to be just one thing.
You can do
a lot. I think this is a kind of the mindset of you can only be one thing. Our parents were one thing for 40 years.
Yes.
Went into offices, hung their coats, and you know,
yeah,
went on the grind.
True.
For so long.
True.
For years and then retired. But I mean, that was their time, and that's what the norm was there back then. But I feel like for us, we have this beautiful opportunity to become and explore a lot of things.
Yes.
Yeah. So for me, if I can learn it and I can do it, I always just challenge myself to do it.
Amazing. I love that mindset, because, you know, I'm just the same. I cannot be boxed into doing one thing. So it's so nice to see that this generation is really putting themselves out there and just doing whatever they want.
Yeah.
And if you get an opportunity, grab it. If it's something different, it's something that's not in your comfort zone, you know, it doesn't matter. But as long as it excites you, you just follow it. Follow,
yeah,
your heart. Follow
and
your gut feeling.
You know, for me, I actually wanted to go to law school. I'm the one who insisted in going to law,
wow,
school. Wow. And I enjoyed my time there. It's just that while I was there, I got into writing,
okay,
more seriously.
Did you finish?
Yes, I did. Though I didn't go to the Kenya School of Law, because by then the creative bug had bit me and I could not think of anything else.
Mm.
So law was still a very passionate side of me, and I still keep my law friends around. I still try to keep abreast with the law, though I can't keep up that much. And then writing came, and it was fun while it lasted.
Mm.
But then I think for me, with that whole spirit of adventure, I decided to simply explore. And I was telling you that things changed, times changed. Instagram, TikTok, well, it started with Vine back,
yes,
then. And then Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube came along. And if, for me, I call myself a storyteller. So if you expect me, or if you want me to tell stories in writing form, I will. With photography, I will. And now with video, I'm learning to.
Amazing. What an adventurous journey you've had these past few years.
Yeah.
Magunga, now, you know, just recently you covered the rally,
yeah,
and you got to experience just the excitement that the rally had. How was it this year? Was it bigger than last year? What was the experience like? You were there last year as well.
Yes.
How would you compare the 2 years? And do you think it's going to get even bigger as time goes by?
So, you know, last year was my first time attending any rally ever.
Wow.
Yes, it was. I didn't grow up going to watch the rally. I don't know why. Actually, but they asked my elder siblings why we didn't do a lot of rally.
Yeah, when we were younger. It was
yeah,
here.
But I grew up in Kisumu. Okay. I don't think in our area it was a thing.
Yeah.
So when last year the WRC was coming back to Kenya, I got an opportunity to do a co-drive, you know, in an R1 car. And that was amazing. I was hooked from the get-go.
And with one of, you know, the international drivers?
Yes.
And you were in the car?
Yes, with Adrian Fomo.
How was that experience?
Oh, my God. The only way I can put it is I would never do it again, but I would want to. I would really want to do it again, but I would never do it again.
Okay.
Because it is thrilling. The thrill is in the...
Was your heart up here?
Up here.
Yeah.
Listen, at the end of the co-drive, I had an interview with I think WRC TV or whatever,
yes.
And I couldn't get a word out because all the English disappeared somewhere along the way. But yeah, so that was my first experience, and now this time I was going back. So that one was Red Bull. This time was Safaricom. Mm. I just wanted to capture the rally and see what I can make out of it. And of course, last year when I went, I didn't get the opportunity to shoot a lot because I didn't know what I was going to shoot.
Yeah.
But this time I came back with a bit of experience in covering it. And yes, for me, I think it was different. It wasn't bigger or better because I feel like the crowds were bigger last year than it was this year.
Yes.
But this year was different in the sense of the opportunities that I got and the kind of footage that I did. So if you saw the video that I posted, it is much different from what I covered last year, you know. And I mean, I hope next year and the years to come, I get to just like grow and grow more in that. I badly want to be accredited next year so that I can move around, you know, get different perspective shots and, you know, insights with the drivers and that kind of thing.
Oh, amazing. What a journey. And that's what you call growth, right?
Yes.
A lot of people believe... Go on.
No, it's a meme. It's from Insecure.
Okay.
Never mind.
Okay, fine. So, you know, a lot of people believe that this content creation industry that we're in, it's not really sustainable. You know, back in the day, I remember people would say that, oh, I'm a content creator or I'm a YouTuber or I'm a photographer, but I also have a 9-to-5 job because it doesn't pay enough. Do you think that stereotype or that perspective has completely changed? The narrative is totally different now, where you can just be a photographer and still, you know, make enough money to pay all your bills, or do you think that sometimes you still need to have different side hustles?
I do not know what a 9-to-5 is.
Wow.
I have been
have
employed.
Have you ever had a 9-to-5
employed,
job?
I've been employed. It was, so both of them were marketing agencies, so it was not typically 9-to-5.
Okay.
But I was there as a copywriter on both agencies, and I lasted 3 months in one and 3 months in another. So beyond that, all my bread has been earned through my creative talents.
Amazing.
Yeah. So just writing on my blog, that was my, it's not even 9-to-5. That's like a
24-hour work shift.
Yeah. So there is this joke, I quit my 9-to-5 because I wanted to be free and
this
I started
so
my
true.
Own job, and then now I work 24/7.
I've seen that as well.
Yeah.
I relate.
I mean, listen, when I have a client or when we have a job going on, it's not even 9-to-5 because I can't clock in and clock out and do my shift my shift is until the job ends, you know. So for me, that's been the life I've known throughout.
Wow.
I've not known any other thing. So if it's in writing, if it's in photography, if it's in content creation, which I'm now doing, you know, it's all I've known, honestly. I would be a terrible example for somebody who wants to compare 9-to-5 to,
yes,
you know, to this, because I've not experienced this other side.
Interesting.
Ever since I left campus, that's...
Yeah.
Content creation is what I've done.
So tell us about this side, content creation, now that you've said that this is all you know.
Yeah.
Does it pay?
It does pay. I am a living testament.
yes.
of it. When I was leaving law school and I told my mother I wanted to be a writer, you can imagine the fight that ensued.
I can only imagine.
You can imagine the fight that ensued. But by and by, I think with that, I got the motivation to prove people wrong, that this is actually something I can do. And so the content I was doing was on my blog, and I was interviewing people and telling stories and all that kind of stuff. And even in that, corporates and mostly corporates came in, you know, because they want to advertise. So they're like, would you tell our stories? Would you interview this person? Would you interview this person? And they pay for it.
Wow.
The same I see with everything else. With photography, I'm not really, I think for me, the skills that I've learned, I incorporated them into my storytelling.
Yes.
So that I don't think anybody pays me to take pictures of them. I don't do that. But photography kind of enhances my storytelling. So if, for instance, Jumbo Jet was my client for a long time. And you're telling travel stories. There is just so much words you can use. Sometimes people just want to see what you're talking about. So if you're down in Diani or in Rift Valley or in Kisumu,
right?
You know, so photography and videography is going to help you tell the stories of these places. You know, so that came in as part of my arsenal. So in my arsenal, there is writing, there is photography, there is now video that's coming up. So when you call me to tell stories of your brand, if it's if let's say it's an alcohol brand or a soft drink, I will use the talents that are in my arsenal to tell the story of this. So that, yeah, that kind of thing.
Okay, interesting. I really like where, you know, we're heading with this conversation. Magunga, you know, you recently got engaged, and congratulations, firstly. Secondly, I want to talk about your video. You know, I watched that video and I was like, wow, this is beautiful. Like, the man has literally planned his entire proposal and he's like got such a beautiful video out, and, you know, to show your story and the love that you share and how interesting you made it. I mean, did you plan that with your videographer?
Honestly, there is just so much you can plan.
Okay.
I don't have an experience planning engagement videos. Or, you know, I don't have any experience. Yes. That was my first time, and hopefully my last time. So I had the idea. I was working with Serena at the time.
Yes.
They invited me to go to Kilaguni, and at the time I had a ring. So I told them, listen, yes, I'm coming. I'm going to do the job. Of course, our content creation jobs, but I want to propose to this lady.
Yeah.
So they said sawa. So they gave me options. There was what's the name of this lake? Not Lake Kivu. I'm forgetting the name of that lake that is in Savo West. It borders Kenya and Tanzania.
Okay.
But when we got there was a lot of construction going on. KWS had just pulled down their campsite and they were putting up something else. So on that day, imagine we drove about 3 hours to the lake. There was a lot of dust, because if you've been to Savo, it's just that loose red dust.
Yes.
and we got there and we could not see anything.
Wow.
You know, so we told them, guys, let's head back.
Yeah.
Let's head back. Let's go back to that sunset spot that you guys were talking about. So it's another 3 hours back in that dust. So when we got back, this girl is tired, and I'm like, listen, let's just do this one last thing.
Yeah.
It's the last day.
Yeah.
Let's just do this one last thing, and then we can come back and rest.
Yeah.
And she's like, okay, fine. And I'm like, yeah. So we went, but let me tell you, by the time we got to Lions Rock,
yeah,
I was just so
tired.
I was kind of restless.
Oh.
Yeah, because you see, I have this thing that is secret that I've had to keep secret for like a whole week. And I just want to get it done with.
Yeah.
But I don't want to just get it done with. I also want it to
be special.
Yeah, I want to make it
memorable.
Nice. So I was so nervous and restless. And it's Goofy and Teti Sulu, man. I can't thank those guys enough, because they came through in a big way for me. And all that footage, videography, photography, it was
they
both
handled
of them.
It.
I didn't do anything. All I had to do was focus on this lady. So later on in the evening, of course, with all that excitement, we have a lot of phone calls to make. I'm called to their room. They're like, we're done with the pictures. And the video came later, but the pictures, man, I couldn't believe it. Exactly what I wanted.
It's amazing.
Yeah, because I just knew I wanted something different.
Yeah.
And I knew she would appreciate something different. Mm. I didn't ask her how she wanted it.
Of course.
Yeah. Mm. I guess that's the only thing I'll ever do by myself with this. So yeah. Everything else now involves family, my family, her family, friends.
And the works.
And the works. I mean, you'd know.
I have experience, first-hand experience.
Yeah.
Let me tell you in advance. You are not ready.
Man, I don't think I'm ready. But I'm
watching?
Excited to experience.
Huh? Is she watching tonight?
I hope she is. She was not feeling very well when I left. Okay. But yeah, I told her.
Is she a number one fan?
Of me?
Yeah.
Yes. I mean, listen. She comes through when she helps me with my work. When I want to put out content, I'm like, are you willing to come feature in this content? Because you have to ask.
Yes,
you know,
of course.
it's not something that is...
Just because you're babe doesn't mean you'll do it.
No. And I am the one who has a contract with these guys. So this is just her helping me. And I help her with her work. So she helps me with mine.
Amazing.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
I love it. Love to hear it. Magunga, what's your plan in future? Is there something that you really want to do? Something that you want to try out that, you know, you've not been able to so far in your career?
So, for me, I've always just wanted to tell stories. Honestly speaking, that's the only thing that I've been interested in. When I started with writing and then with photography and now with video, that's all I'm ever interested in, because I think that's now my vocation. So the dream, of course, is to tell more meaningful, more impactful stories, both in Kenya, Africa, and global. I hope to one day, you know, reach those heights that everyone hopes for. That's my only dream, to tell more stories, to be around, to tell more stories, to have the resources and the financial ability, because money plays a big role in all of this, to get as much exposure as possible. You know, I would love to be part of a movie.
Okay.
Not as acting, though.
Yes.
Writing.
Okay.
The writing part of it.
You'd love to feature in a Saudi Soul video.
I would love to feature. Listen, where is my camera? Which one is my camera?
Oh. There we go.
Hey, Saudi Soul, listen. I would really, really love to be in one of your videos. I mean, I don't know how to say that. And you know, I've been around them a lot.
Yeah.
Because of mutual friends. But I've never really gotten the, you know, the guts to ask, hey, so when are you guys shooting your next video? Because also you don't seem like you, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, but I feel like that's not really... I don't know what that would ever do for me. I think it's more vanity than anything, because I love that group so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, BN, Chimano.
Manifest. Let's make it happen, right?
Yeah.
And as we wind up, anything that you'd like to tell any upcoming photographers who are trying to break it into the industry, just any message that you have for them, any word of advice as we finish off?
The only thing I can ever tell anyone who is getting into photography, videography, content creation, listen, it takes time. So give it time. Nothing good ever happens like this. For many people, and you see, for us, when we started a long time ago, we've seen people come, blow up more than we have, and continue. But for us, we just stay true. You know, you can never compare yourself with other people. So you don't look at a finished product and then you hope to achieve that in a couple of days, you know.
Mm.
So just give it time. With skill, with marketing, with finances, it will all take time.
Okay.
And I really hope and wish all the best to them.
Oh, I love that advice. Thank you so much for coming through. This
You're
has
welcome.
Been an exceptional conversation. You know, quite an eye opener. Just so much to learn from you.
Yeah.
You're very well spoken, by the way.
Just, oh, thank you.
Just thought I'd let you know.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And
thank you so much.
Yes, I hope and, you know, wish you all the very best. May all your dreams come true in future. And just keep keep doing your thing, because you know you're very inspiring.
And you too, to you
Thank
too, because you are an inspiration. Listen, we are working with you on the same campaign. We share a client, and I look at your content, and I'm.
Thank
so
you.
So even for you, just. Yeah. Keep it up.
Asante sana. Yeah. I did not pay him to say that. I didn't pay him, by the way.
Oh,
just
she did.
In case.
She did.
I've impressed him a little bit. Anyways, thank you so much, Magunga. You know, we'll do this again next week. Same time, same place. We'll have another guest. So make sure you tune in. This has been Hashtag Easy Friday. Good night to you from me and Magunga. But don't go too far, because Coljax is up next with Disco Funk to get that Friday fever in. Coljax, let's go.
Heru ukwe maskini, lakini ukwe mzima.
Ukiwa na health mzuri, shukuru Mungu.
Some of them don't even understand the kind of sickness that they are suffering from. But thank you, because through mama here, we have seen the hand of God.
Nashukuru, nilitibiwa, sasa naendelea kupona.
Lakini mulisupport, nikaweza kupona, sasa niko na raha, Mungu awabariki.
Nilikava kabisa, niko na furaha sana.
The only show that is transforming lives.
Mungu akubariki na Mungu akuzidishie.
Kupata mithali 6:20 kama sikiza tune kwenye simu yako, bonyeza *811*817#.
Mithali 6:20. Mwanangu, shika maagizo ya baba yako, wala usisahau mafundisho ya mama yako. Yaweke daima moyoni mwako. Yafunge shingoni mwako. Yatakuongoza njiani mwako. Yatakulinda wakati ulalapo.
Kupata mithali 6:20, bonyeza *811*817#. *811*817#.
My trust is in you. Jumapili hii kwenye runinga ya KBC, ungana naye Askofu Michael Wanderi wa kanisa la Christian Foundation Fellowship Kiambu kuanzia saa 1 hadi saa 2 asubuhi.
Ningetaka nikwambie our Jehovah God, because the Bible says he is the same yesterday, today and forevermore. He is able to take you to a place of abundance. He is able to take you to Rehobothi in the name of Jesus Christ.
Kipindi ni neno la neema, ukiletewa naye Askofu Michael Wanderi wa kanisa la Christian Foundation Fellowship Kiambu. Usikose.
Our arts and entertainment industry has evolved over the years.
It is at such times that our destinies are written. Will we rise up in courage or die in cowardice?
The movers and shakers in film and theater. Get trendy as we review locally produced films and stage drama every Wednesday at 9 p.m. on Cinemas and Theater.
Brought to you by the Kenya Film Commission. Film Kenya, capture Africa.
Cold Jack. Yeah.